be advised, do not pull too much brake pressure. That is a way you could hurt yourself. Do not try this without an instructor.
Thanks to all of the individuals who commented on that last video, and whoever suggested, I forget who it was, to put the wing bag underneath in this container right here. I'm gonna try that out. If it works, huge thanks to you guys. Let's try it.
Oh man.
So your suggestion worked. Anybody who commented in that last video where I was had an aborted landing, thank you very much for making that suggestion to put the wing bag in. Now I know that if I ever land out or if I'm doing a cross-country flight, I'll be taking the wing bag with me. So today, I really want to practice my landings. There's this perfect sod farm that is massive. It is the ideal place to practice any sort of like paramotoring type stuff. And whenever there's something that I need to work on, I like to come to a big place that's super forgiving. And today, I'm going to be practicing my landings. There's really not much of a wind right now, but I know that I'm gonna send it in this direction-ish because that's where I feel the wind coming from. So I'm going to actually take my wing bag back out of the bag and use it for my spot landing practice.
Get a little more bumpy as that sun continues to get higher into the air. There's the camera and there's the bag. I'm going for the bag. I don't know if I'll be able to keep this insta out. It's kind of wanky, wanky. And, oh no, I'm going to overshoot it. Oh no. Damn, and I'm moving fast. This is going to be tough with the Insta 360. Here's what we're going to do. I'm gonna go ahead and stow the Insta 360 after I finish this pass right here along this awesome sprinkler system that keeps this sod farm looking so juicy. Once we complete that, then we're gonna go ahead and do our go around and set ourselves up for some landing practice. I'm gonna predict I'm between 30 and 40 feet, and I think that's a really good altitude to initiate this swoop landing at. Once again, if you're too low, your wing is gonna drop and head you to the direction of the ground. Which is what you want just periodically, but you want the energy to kind of carry more off into a straightened level, you know, so you can build that energy off, apply the brakes, and have an effective flare. Oh man, okay, the wind direction seems to have changed slightly. I'm going to adjust for a slightly different direction. Where is the wind? Let's see here. So the wind has changed since I laid out the wing. I really think it's coming from this way. Okay, let's check this real quick. Yeah, that looks good. I don't think it's this so much. Nope. It's gonna be like right in between the truck. So like right here. Okay, here we go. Ah, no. Let's test the good approach theory. Like the long final. Okay, rolling out of that, put us on that heading. Man, I mean, I'm telling you, the wind is definitely coming out of the west-ish. There's the bag, brake pressure, swoop, and full flare. Oh, no, I missed it. Touch and go. try that one again. Woohoo! First one was not on the bag. Okay, putting my seat back underneath me, turning base to a quick final. I'm just gonna round out the base to final. All right, we're lined up again. I'm feeling a lot more confident. Maybe I shouldn't. Okay, this is a good approach. I am feeling it. Here we go. Okay, good. I want to start earlier this time and swoop it in a little bit and hold that energy. Yes, yes, yes. Oh, I touched it. Swoopy doopy doopy doo. Okay, once again, I'm going to apply a little bit of brake pressure right before, I don't know, maybe like 100 feet before I get there. Let's see. Okay, I'm going to hold brakes and get a little energy. And... you know what? On this approach, I've made an executive decision that I'm just gonna do the traditional way of landing a paramotor, how they teach it in flight training, which is to go hands up. Like, you go hands up, you glide it in. The problem is you're not going to be as accurate if you do this method, but I'm gonna go hands up. Hands up, okay. Gliding, oh shit, man, I'm not good at this. And flare, oh man, actually that wasn't bad. Whoa. Okay, that wasn't too bad actually, okay? Let's try that one more time, okay? Okay, I'm gonna call it right now. Okay, this is my glide. This is my glide. I'm feeling it, baby. Come on. No, I'm gonna overshoot it. No, go around. All right, on those last two ones, I kept my hands all the way up. As I got closer to the ground, like really close, within like 10 feet, I started to apply that pressure, burn off that energy, but I'm not doing very well. I'm going back to my swoopy method. Let's try that. Ready? Little brake pressure and swoop it in. Build that energy, build that energy. Build it. Oh, scoots right back. Back on to full power for the go around. All right. I want to do it earlier this time. I'm going to, there it is. And swoop me in, please. Swoop me in. Oh, that wasn't bad. Look at that. Oh, what a juicy foot drag. Yeah, that was fun. You want to be high, right? You want to be high and let your wing really naturally curve out. Since the wing wants to fly level on its own, like, let it do its thing, and then it's gonna carry as much energy as it, oh man, did that wind shift? We've got our dust coming from the farm next door to show us the direction of the wind. It is the best windsock you could ask for. Okay, nice. Our dust sock is reading accurately. I want to get higher. Oh, almost. Here we go. Into the wind, climb up. Pressure. Whoa.
Thank you.
If you enjoyed this video, please subscribe to the channel and click that like button. Go ahead and check out one of these videos if you enjoyed this one. Also, if you're feeling kind of frisky, this is the one down here that YouTube recommends. Might be good, might not, but it's what YouTube thinks you want to watch. Until next time, blue skies and fly safe.